good morning. We need a move, God. We are expecting for you to move through this prayer line on today, dear Lord. This is a fabulous Friday. This is Rise and Pray. Lives depend on it. Lives depend on you and me to get on this prayer line Monday through Friday from 5:55 a.m. to 6:15. We try to end on time, even though we want to keep going. We thank God for your presence on today. We thank all returning callers. We thank you, Facebook Live and YouTube. And we especially thank those who are just new, coming on board, getting in line with the movement of God. It's so awesome that he is moving through this prayer line, shaking our firm foundation, shaking those things that need to get out of the way, and making us whole through this prayer line. We declare it to be so on this fabulous Friday. Let me recap. On Monday, we prayed about who is our Jehovah Rapha. Reveal yourself to us. We need a healing. We want to declare the works of the Lord. On Tuesday, our devotional day, we talked about don't quit in the pit. Don't have a quitting spirit. You are a child of the Most High God. You got to know that your sunshine is coming around that corner, God. Your new day, your fresh wind is coming around the corner. And on Wednesday, we discussed some tools and techniques that we needed to survive the pit experience. And on Thursday, our prayer warrior came and said, identify and know the difference between an attack and a test. You got to know when you got to rebuke Satan and when you got to ride this thing out. And so let's determine today that we're going to pass that test. Hallelujah. On today's fabulous Friday, we are going to 1 Corinthians 15, 55 to 58 in the King James Version. Again, that's 1 Corinthians 15, 55 to 58 in the King James Version. We all have something to celebrate during this week. Find something to give God the glory for. Something worked your way this week. Something was a blessing to you. So again, 1 Corinthians 15, 55 through 58. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For as much as ye know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. Unmovable is defined as not moved, not transferred from one place to another, not changed in purpose, unshaken, firm, not affected, not touched or impressed, not altered by passion or emotion. War cry focus. We are unmovable because God is still moving. Let me say that again. We are unmovable because God is still moving. Dear gracious and eternal Father, we thank you for this day. God, we love you like never before on today, God. God, you have shown yourself to be our Jehovah Rapha, and we appreciate you on this morning. We blow kisses to you on this morning, and we say you deserve all our praise, all our glory, and all the honor, Father God, because you are our great I Am, God. We thank you for having compassion on us on this morning. We thank you for revealing your mysteries to us, Father. We thank you for unveiling your word to us, Daddy God. Thank you, God, because we are so enlightened by you and so encouraged by you that we know that there's nothing to us bowing down and giving you glory and honor, unto you, Father God. We bow ourselves to you, God, in this place right now. This is holy ground, God. Wherever we stand right now, it is holy ground. And we thank you, Lord Jesus. We thank you for your disposition of grace, God. Dispensation of grace. We thank you for your grace that has come upon us, God. We thank you for forgiving us of all our sins and everything that we said and did that was not pleasing in your sight, God. We ask you, Father God, in the name of Jesus, to help us not be carnally minded, because carnally minded is death, God. But help us to be spiritually minded, which brings life and peace, God, in the name of Jesus. We understand that there is no condemnation to them who are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. So, God, we thank you today that you have already forgiven us, transformed us, and renewed our minds, God. In the name of Jesus, we thank you that we know the difference between conviction and condemnation, God. And you didn't come in this world to condemn us. You came in this world to convict us. And conviction, even though, Father God, we may have tears of sorrow, Father God, after that, God, we are rejoicing in you, because we thank you that you are a Father that chasteneth whom you loveth, God. In the name of Jesus, so thank you, Father God, for meeting us right where we are. Thank you, God, that your word declares if we make our bed in hell, you are with us. So we thank you for never leaving us or not forsaking us on this morning. Thank you, God, for helping us maneuver through this world, God, even though we're not of this world. You still guide and protect us. You sent your comforter to be there with us as we maneuver through things and obstacles and tests and attacks, God. You are there, God, in the name of Jesus. So forgive us, Father God, for every thought, every deed that we have done. Forgive us for every assumption and every ungodly perception of things, God, in the name of Jesus. Renew our mind on today. God, we put a special prayer for the sick and shut in, God, in the name of Jesus. We pray, Father God, right now that you dispatch your angels, God. We pray right now that through this prayer line that the healing of the Holy Ghost will be felt on those right now that have an infirmity, every headache, God, to go. In the name of Jesus, give us a mind, Father God, that is stayed on thee, because if we stay on you, you will give us perfect peace, God. On today, you're going to do it for those that are sick and shut in, God. We ask you to heal every ligament, God, every bone defect, God. In the name of Jesus, multiple sclerosis, you got to go. In the name of Jesus, God, we pray for those in abusive relationships, God. Every abusive relationship, God, I'm asking you to renew the mind of the person that's being abused, God. Give them strength, God, in the name of Jesus. Help them to identify that this is not a test, but this is an attack, God, in the name of Jesus, that comes to kill, steal, and destroy, God. In the name of Jesus, we pray for those that are in hostile work environments, God. We pray for those that are in the pit, God, in the pit of despair, God. In the name of Jesus, we're asking you that you bring them out of the pit. In the name of Jesus, God, we release those strongholds, God, in relationships that there are conflict and competition, God, that's ungodly, especially in the church house, God. So we come against every competitive demon, because that's a test right there. Testing of our faith. Are we going to walk in love or not, God? In the name of Jesus. So we thank you today for destroying the yokes, God. In the name of Jesus. But your word declares, above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith ye shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked. So dear
mountain, God, in the name of Jesus. Move, God, in the name of Jesus. God, we thank you. We thank you that we're unmovable. Hallelujah. Think about it. Being unmovable is a sign that we have clear direction and we are standing steadfast in our faith. When we are unmovable, we are no longer shaken about an attack or a test, and we see the pit as an opportunity to minister to others rather than desiring to quit. Remember, God is getting the glory out of our circumstances. Be ye unmovable, because God is still moving on your behalf. It is in Jesus' name we do pray. Please have a blessed weekend and keep your joy on this day. Amen and amen. Have a great one.